Welcome at AQH, the channel for online tutorials and more. This tutorial I'll explain how to make a Flappy Bird feel like game in the Godot engine. Godot is an open source engine with its own language and it's all about object-oriented game design. We will only use 2D nodes for this game. Click on the tab to create a new object or scene. Change the name with your right mouse button and click rename. You can do this with any node in the scene manager. With the right mouse button you can also add shells to your object. Godot names any properties or elements childs, which you can attach on your object or the parent. Add a kinematic body on the player, this body allows user input. And we add in the same way two different child objects, the sprite child and the collision shape 2D. In this tutorial I will reuse my own pixel bird and pipe we made in the Game Maker Flappy Bird tutorial. You can drag any sprites you want in the file system manager. Click on the sprite child and drag the bird into the texture in the inspector manager. Now we will add the rectangular shape on the collision shape 2D and make it align with the bird. Add the area 2D child with its own collision shape 2D, which we will use for collision detection. Save the scene and add a new 2D node. This will be the node for the wall sprite. For this object we will add a static body 2D. In the same way as before, we will add a sprite and a collision 2D node. We will drag the sprite in the texture and adjust the collision 2D shape. Click on the static body and detach a script. Create a new function which will be called every frame, the function physics process delta. Don't worry if you don't really know exactly what you need to type. Often the Godot search engine is good enough for the auto search. You want to change the position, which is an inbuilt property. And we'll use the vector 2D to change its X position with every frame. In the same way we will add a script on the player. Click on the player node and its body and attach a script. Now create three constant variables. One up with a vector 2D. A boost with the constant variable for the jump. And one gravity to pull the player down. Next we will create the variable motion with an empty vector object. Create the physics process function and change the I value from the motion. This is the second value of the vector 2D, which we kept open, and we are going to add our constant gravity. In the same function we will add an if statement to check if a button is pressed. I will use the standard UI button called UI accept, and we can check in the input map which buttons are connected in this statement. The enter, the KP enter and the spacebar. If this button is pressed, we will manipulate the motion I again, but this time minus the boost. Add a moves and slide function to move the player. When coding, you shouldn't be messy. Most errors are typing mistakes or placement mistakes. Untap the moving slide function to take the statement out of the if statement. Create a new 2D node. This will be the level object. Add the player in the level by clicking on the link button and drag the bird to the center of the screen. Repeat this step by adding the pipes and duplicate a couple of them. Move the pipes around to create a linear level. Save the level node somewhere on your computer before you can start a scene. Now we already have the elements working, but we need to add more interactivity to the game. Let's add a spawner to make it more random. Right click on the player node and make it local so we can add a trigger. Add a new area 2D on the player node and assign it a collision shape 2D to set the boundaries of the trigger. Assign a rectangular shape, change the size and drag it just outside of the game screen. Change its name to resetter to keep an overview where the object is. Click on the node tab and select body entered body node and connect it with the player. Godot automatically created the function in the script. To be able to connect the wall sprites with this object, we need to create a new variable and use the preload function. We need to copy the path of the scene of the pipes and paste it within the quotation marks to make the connection. To be able to check in the debug manager if the collision works, we will add the print function called test test or whatever text to appear when the collision happens. Create a new function which we will call within the trigger. In the trigger itself, we want to create an if statement to check if a body with a particular name entered the area 2D node. Go back to the pipes to change the name of the static body. Go back in the script and use the same name. Be aware that the name is case sensitive. Add body Q3 to check if the X and Y position is free. Copy the name of your reset function. Add another print text to check if the function will be called. You can test your scene now and check if you receive the two printed text in your output. Reopen our script and create a variable instance to make it equal to our wall object. Set the wall instance position with the vector 2D value and we will make the X and Y value random. We use the rand underscore range for this. Check in the level scene the max and the minus X and Y values by checking those values in the inspector so we can drag the pipes to see different values. We will use this information in the rand range function to make the X and the Y value random but still playable and visible in the screen. Now we need to use the getParent to call deferred to add this new object as a child. To reset the game we will use the same technique. Click on the area 2D and connect the body enter node. We will have now a new function. Copy the if body statement and reuse it. And use the get underscore dot reload current scene to reset the game when the bird hits one of the pipe. As we want to restart the game when the bird falls off the screen, we add a new area 2D child with a collision shape 2D and resize this collision to fit just under our scene. Add in the same way that we did before the body enter node and copy the get underscore dot reload in this new function. Now we have a scene that resets itself very well. Let's make staying alive more rewarding by adding score. On the level node, add a canvas layer child with a rich text label which has a timer as a child attached. You can change the score color under its visibility tab in the inspector. Attach a new script on the rich text label. Create the variable for the points and add a process delta function with a set text and use the variable of the point. Click on the timer and its node tab and click on timeout to connect it with our script. In this function, we will use the point value and count it up by +1. In the inspector itself, we check the auto start. On the setText point string, you can add a text in quotation to appear before the counter to type a text like points or so or whatever you like. Now the game is ready to be played. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial as I did my best to explain all the little details so next time you can make your own game. This was A Creates. Have a nice day, make more, enjoy more.